Alright guys, so I'm getting ready for work, slash got my face ready for work. This is my robe. Super classy. So if you want to see how I got this, look right now. Just stick around. So I am going to start off by priming my paint pot in Painterly with my fluffy brush. Oh, my lid. I don't know why I'm talking like that. But this is what I'm doing. Alright, so the next color I'm going to use is Gold Digger. Focus. And I was looking for Trophy Wife, and I'm pretty sure I look for Trophy Wife every single time I go to use a gold. And I don't believe I have it, and I think I need to get it because it is beautiful. So I moistened my brush just a bit with some Fix Plus. And, oh boy. Tapping it off in the lid and then applying by patting across the eyelid, and I'm revisiting the cap as I need more. Next, over the last third of the lid, so right here in the outer corner kind of area, from about here to there, I'm going to be applying the color Bobbin for Apples. This one was a limited edition fall color from a few years back, and I would say, I don't know this for sure because my Halloween shadows are put away right now, but I believe Vampire Wedding is kind of close, but I think it's going to be one of your best kind of dupes for this from the current selection. And that one also is actually a limited edition. I believe there's only 2 Halloween sets left of each variety. And then to make this pop a little more, because it's kind of dulling down on top of my Gold Digger, I've wet the brush a bit, and I'm going to, there we go, livens it up a little bit there. And then I'm going to dry the brush off a bit, and I'm going to work those together. So, dry the brush off and then just kind of bring in those two together. Also, if you're not great with transitions just yet, you can always use a more orangey color to kind of help you along in between the two, but I think we'll be good here. I'm just gonna grab a little bit more of my Gold Digger. And there we go. Alright, so for this go-round, I am actually going to be using a little bit of Glamour Doll Eyes Foil Me. And I'm going to be using my Doe Foot applicator bottle. And the reason I'm going to be using that is actually because I'm going to, and I know I shouldn't, but I'm going to stick the end of my pencil brush in there, if it'll fit. Oh, it doesn't, but it just kind of dusted the edges, so it got a little bit on there. And then what I'm going to do is with the shadow that I'm going to be using, which is Feverish, I'm pouring, oh god, a little bit, which ended up being a lot of it. So, getting a little bit of that in the cap of the shadow, and then dipping the brush in. So right now it looks like that. And then I'm going to tap it off. Because now I'm gonna. No, it looks like this. Come on, focus. And I'm gonna put that right there in my crease area. So let me turn my mirror here so I'm still facing you guys a little bit.
And then I'm gonna redip because I want a little bit more on the outside corner and a bit more coming in. So then,
after that, I'm gonna take a fluffy brush like this. And I'm just gonna run that over what I just put down. It's clean, there's nothing on it. That's just to kinda soften those edges a little bit. And I will probably add a little bit more of Feverish, which I'm actually gonna go ahead and do. So now I've dipped that in there. I'm gonna add a little bit more on this outside corner. And that is it for Feverish. Okay, so next I'm gonna take the color Corpselike. This one's from the 2012 Halloween Shadows collection. And I'm using just a flat shader brush, taking a bit on the kinda tip there. Woo! And running that underneath the brow. And you see it looks kind of stark right now, then I'm going to use the rest of the brush to kind of pull it down a little and smooth it out so it's not just line. Okay, so now I'm going to go back into just the lid of Bobbin for Apples, that red color. So this is what my brush looks like, and I'm actually going to tap it off. And then what I'm going to do is just kind of run that right on that top edge of where the Feverish color stops and starts to meet the highlight, just to give it a little bit of extra warmth there, and add another little bit of color. And then I'm going to clean up my edges with some makeup remover as well before I start the face makeup. I thought I was recording this whole time. I just added some of my Glamour Doll Eyes Foil Me from my dropper bottle. I put it on the back of my hand, and then I used this flat brush to apply some to my lid, and then I used my MAC Reflex Gold sample, because I didn't get any of the gold glitter eyelight. So now I have glitter all over here. And now I'm going to go ahead and apply some liner, and I'll be back. Alright, so here we are going another round with the pencil brush and Feverish. I applied my liner, and I just want something on the underside to kind of give me a little bit more darkness on the outer corner of my eye. So what I'm doing is I took a little bit on the end and just using that pencil brush to kind of bring some of that through the lower lash line there on both sides. And that's just personal. I wasn't even in the frame, was I? Words. So, there you have that. I'm gonna apply some mascara and some lashes and the rest of my face, and I'll show you what all this looks like when I'm done. Okay guys, so this is the completed look. I don't know what the lipsticks are because they came out of my little kit palette thing that I made. So yeah, if you have any questions, leave them below, and I will see you guys all again soon. Bye!